Some people aren't fortunate enough to ever even meet their grandparents. But if there's one person I can say has been a pleasure knowing, has had a huge impact on my life, it's my pop, William Fogarty Sr. Bill was born in Queens, New York on October 27, 1934. He was the oldest of six children, raised by his parents, John and Irene Fogarty, in a small apartment perched above a storefront on the streets of Queens. One thing that he was taught by his father from a young age, especially as the oldest son, was that if he was going to make it as an Irishman in the boroughs of New York, he was going to have to work for everything he got. Without ever complaining, he did just that. Instead of playing games or having fun, he spent most of his childhood and high school years working many different jobs to help him and his family live comfortably throughout the years. For a boy who knew nothing but work most of his young life, he made the decision out of high school to join the United States Navy. While most of his friends had college aspirations, my pop saw naval ships in open water. He served 4 years mostly working in the kitchen, but before long he discovered a true passion, boxing. Any chance he could get, he was in the ring training and waiting for his next bout. In 10 matches in the Navy, he saw no blemishes on a spotless 10-0 record. He loved the competitive fire he got from boxing and enjoyed it was one of the things he enjoyed most in his time in the Navy. There was only one thing that influenced him to walk away from the Navy and his love of boxing. A woman named Carol, his eventual wife, my Nana. The two first met at a naval dance that they actually attended with separate dates. As my Nana used to describe it, he was better looking, so I made my move. The two fell quickly in love. My pop left the Navy and wasted no time starting the next chapter of his life. By 23, Bill and Carol Fogarty were married and ready to start a family. That same year, the newlyweds tried having their first child, but unfortunately lost the baby when my grandmother experienced a miscarriage. After working through the emotional sadness of their loss, they decided to try again in early 1958. Sure enough, on the night of December 29, 1958, my pop officially became William Fogarty Sr., as my father, the oldest of six boys, was born. After having two more boys in Queens, Gregory and Mike, my pop realized he didn't want his children to live the same way he did, cramped in one apartment in the heart of Queens. So he picked up and moved his family to Westbury on Long Island. After moving to the suburbs, my other three uncles were born, Glenn, Gary, and Pat, finishing off the group of six. One of the things I admire most about my pop is his endless work ethic. After moving to Westbury, he started a job working for the town of Hempstead Parks Department, where he worked for over 40 years. Every day after work, he would come home, cook dinner for his family, quickly eat something, and head out to a second job. It varied what the job was over the years, but he did this day in and day out for years, just to help his family thrive and live comfortably. Upon retiring, he was graced with the pleasure of having seven grandchildren, whom he would seemingly do anything for. The amount of times he's helped me and my sister out alone is hard to count. I know my pop's door is always open. Unfortunately, in December of 2010, my Nana passed away after fighting a slight case of Alzheimer's and experienced two separate strokes. Along the way, the one constant was my pop by her side. Whatever she needed, whatever pills she needed to take, or doctor's appointment she needed to attend, he was there to take it. As of today, my pop is still doing quite well, very healthy. He walks a mile a day, cooks dinner every night for his family, wakes up every morning just to bring two of my cousins to school. This past October, we celebrated 80 years of Bill. 80 hard-working, loving years. I know I'm not the first person to ever say this, but I truly hope to grow up one day to be half the man my pop has been.